Today's notes, again, we are applying trigonometry to quadrilaterals. So we're not learning anything new. We're just going to take a look at our quadrilaterals. Based on what's given, we're going to find a missing angle and a missing side. Sometimes we'll have a right angle that's given. If there's a right angle given, we're going to use the trig ratios. And that was, there was a saying that we used to help us remember, and that saying was SOHCAHTOA. So sine of an angle is opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine of an angle is the ratio of the side adjacent to the hypotenuse. And tangent of an angle is opposite over adjacent. That's having a right angle. We learned other ways or other formulas that would give us another method of finding a side or an angle without having a right angle. And that was the law of cosines and law of sines. So let's draw the triangle up top again. So there's no right angle. Remember the notation. The side opposite angle A, so all of the angles are given with capital letters. The side opposite an angle is given with a lowercase letter with the same letter. Okay, so opposite angle A is side A. Opposite angle B is side B, and opposite angle C is side C. Law of cosines said you had to have all three sides in one angle. So law of cosines said, given an angle and the side opposite, here's the law. It's that side squared equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides minus 2 times the product of those two sides, those sides that are not opposite the angle, but cosine of the angle that's given. So the angle that you have here, cosine C and side C, have to match. One on the left side of the equal sign is the side, and then the other side is the cosine of the angle. Law of sines. For law of sines, you only had to have, so if I get rid of some things in my picture, two sides and two angles. So I guess I could have kept that, so I'll undo that. So I need two sides and two angles, and you need an angle and the side opposite. So this is one ratio, so it would be C over sine of angle C, and you need another side given. So if I'm given angle B, the side opposite would be side B, so it's B over sine of B. Area was still 1/2, and the area formula, just to grab a different colored pen, you need two sides, so say I'm given sides B and C, and it's times the sine of the angle that's included, and the angle included between sides B and C is angle A. In number one, we have a rectangle, so let's draw a rectangle. The length of a diagonal, remember the diagonals are congruent, so I'm going to draw this diagonal, is 15 centimeters. Remember we have a right angle there. The length of the shorter side is 7 centimeters, so I'm going to take a look at this right triangle. I could take a look at the other one. But I'm going to take a look at that one. It says, find in the nearest degree the number of degrees in the angle formed by the diagonal and the longer side. So this angle right here. Because I don't know the other acute angle and I only know two sides, I have to use trig. And according to the angle, we're given the side opposite and we're given the hypotenuse. So that's sine. So sine of the angle is 7/15. And remember, to find the angle, we do it on the calculator. We do the inverse sine of 7/15, and we take the decimal. So we have someone using the calculator here in class, but we should all be typing it in to make sure that we get the same thing as the person typing it in for us. So 27.8181.3928, that is correct. to the nearest degree, the angle is approximately 28. In number two, I put a rhombus on the page just to make it go a little bit quicker. So we have rhombus ABCD, each side is 20 and DAB is 52. So DAB, find diagonal, so DAB is 52, each side is 20, and we're going to find diagonal AC. And we're going to find diagonal BD. And I know in a rhombus, the diagonals are perpendicular. The diagonals are not only perpendicular in a rhombus, but what do they do to this 52 degree angle? They bisect. So each angle is 26 degrees. So I'm going to take a look at this right triangle here. To find AC, I can first find this. In any parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. So once I find that, I just double it to find the whole length. So to find x, we're given the side adjacent and the hypotenuse, so that's cosine. So for part A, the cosine of 26 degrees equals x over 20. Remember, we can put it over 1 and cross multiply. So x is equal to 20 times the cosine of 26 degrees. But remember, AC is equal to 2x, so once I get that answer, I'm going to want to double 2 times 20 cosine of 26 degrees. And then AC is approximately, to the nearest integer would be 36. As you can see, Nick's got it up on the calculator. Part B, find BD to the nearest integer. We're going to do the same thing or something similar. Since BD is here, I'll call this y, and again, because that's the midpoint, this is also y. So to find y, that's the sine, because we have opposite over hypotenuse. So the sine of 26 degrees equals y over 20, and y would be equal to 20 sine of 26. But then BD is equal to 2 times y, which is 20 sine of 26. So let's type that in on the calculator. So BD is approximately, if I'm rounding to the nearest integer, 17.5 would round to 18. Last, it says, find the area of the rhombus using your answers from part A and B. So the area of a rhombus, I'm going to do 1 half diagonal 1 times diagonal 2. So 1 half of 36 times 18. Well, half of 36 is 18, and 18 times 18 is 324. I'll use U since I'm running out of room, square units. So in number 3, it says if two sides of a parallelogram are 8 and 12, and the included angle between those two sides is 120 degrees, find the length of the longer angle. So if one of your angle, okay, is 120, the other angle here is also going to be 120, but those are obtuse, and if these two are obtuse, what's true about the other two? They're acute. You can add them up. Subtract from 360, divide by 2, but the longer diagonal is going to be here, opposite the obtuse angle. So I'm going to call that x. Since there's no right angle, we can't use our trig ratios. So do we use the law of cosines or the law of sines when we're given three sides in an angle? Law of cosines. Three sides in an angle, so law of cosines says the side that's opposite the angle squared is equal to the sum of the other two squares of your other two sides minus 2 times the product of those two sides, cosine of your angle. Remember, we're going to have to take the square root. So x is equal to the plus and minus. We can reject the negative, And it's good to show the work in parts. So let's first start. Nick, can you do 8 squared plus 12 squared? Just to show some work, so that if I was grading this, I could get you some partial credit. 8 squared plus 12 squared is 208. Minus, then what's 2 times 8? 16 times 12. Cosine of 120. So now do the square root of that. And that's going to be our x. So the length of the longer diagonal is approximately, it's the nearest tenth, 17.43, rounds to 17.4. And we're given no units, so we're good. Now the last two have to, they deal with area. So we need to decide when we have to use the area formula with trig, or if we can just do length times width. The first one's a rectangle. We're going to find the area to the nearest square centimeter. Anyone have an idea? Here's our 90 degree angles. You can look at one of the triangles, find the area of a triangle, and double it if you want. But if there's a way to find the length and width, we could just multiply the length and the width, or x times y. So area is length times width. And because of the right angle and the right triangle, we can use trig. X is the side adjacent. So we have adjacent and hypotenuse. So cosine of 36 equals x over 12, and x equals 12 cosine of 36. I'm going to leave it exact for right now. And then y is the side opposite, so that's sine. The sine of 36 degrees equals y over 12, so y is equal to 12 sine of 36 degrees. And then I'm going to replace it here. So the length, 12 cosine of 36 times the width, 12 sine of 36. So on the calculator, what do you get? You could also do 144 cosine of 36 times the sine of 36, however you want to do it. We're rounding to the nearest square centimeter. So the area is approximately 68.4. We're just round to 68. And the last one, two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. Adjacent sides are also consecutive sides, just for vocab. So two adjacent sides are 25 and 26. If the parallelogram contains an angle of 112, well, in my picture, the 112 could be here or here, because these are my obtuse angles. So I'm going to put it there. Find the area of the parallelogram. Now, area of a parallelogram is base times height. We obviously have the base, so this is also 26, but we don't have the altitude. And without giving any, we could find this acute angle, okay, and see if we can use a special right triangle by drawing the altitude of the perpendicular segment. However, the easiest way would be to draw the diagonal and find the area of this triangle and then multiply by 2 to add, because these two triangles are congruent. So the area of this triangle using trig is 1/2 the product of the two sides and the included angle. So it'd be 25 times 26, or 36, I wrote that down wrong, sine of 112. And then we just have to do times 2. What's that? So if you were to write it out, so the area of the parallelogram is really 2 times the area of a triangle. And when you do 2 times 1/2 of 25 times 36 sine of 112, what's half of 2? Half of 2 is 1. Then what's 25 times 36? 25 times 36 is 900. So you can really shorten and just do 900, the sine of 112. And we're going to round to the nearest integer. So 834.4 would round to 834. No units again, so just units squared.